Hey, what is going on, guys? Lon here from Android Authority. And if you're looking for a fitness tracker, there doesn't seem to be any shortage of them. And Sony is getting in on the craze with their own fitness tracker, which we first saw back at CES. But let's go ahead and take a closer look at the Sony Smart Band and find out what it's all about. The Sony Smart Band is the company's first product to be powered by their new core fitness tracker. And in terms of design, the band is comprised of two parts. There's the actual band itself that's made of a textured silicone, and Sony includes a small and large one in the box. They're both adjustable via a two-pronged metal fastener, so it's made to fit virtually any wrist size. The metal fastener feels a little bit clumsy when trying to put it on, so I would have liked to maybe see a magnet or a clasp instead to make it easier to put on. But once it's on your wrist, it feels very secure, and I haven't had any problems with it coming undone. By itself, the band does absolutely nothing, but this is where the second part comes in. This is what Sony calls the core, which is basically the heart of the band, and it essentially is a plastic white rectangle with a micro USB on one end for charging, a power button on the side with three LED indicators, and a Sony logo on the bottom. The core slips into the underside of the band, and once it's on your wrist, it looks like a normal band. Nobody would probably think anything of it if they saw you wear it, and it sort of reminds me of those Livestrong bracelets people used to wear all the time. By default, the Smart Band only comes in black, but Sony is selling colored bands separately if you want to switch things up a bit, or if black is just a little too bland for you. It's also extremely lightweight, so it's very comfortable to wear, and after a while, I pretty much forgot that I was even wearing it. Oh, and if you want to wear it in the shower, you can do that too, as it's rated IP58, making it both dust and water resistant. In order to first start using the Smart Band, you'll have to pair it with your smartphone via NFC or Bluetooth. The only requirement is that you have a phone running Android 4.4 KitKat. The process takes about 5 minutes or so, but it requires you to download three separate apps: the Sony Smart Band app, Sony Connect, and LifeLog. It would have been nice to see Sony integrate them all into a single app, but once you have it all set up, it'll automatically start tracking your activity. Since the band doesn't have a display, pretty much all of the Smart Band settings and activity tracking has to be viewed on your phone. Within the Smart Band app, you can adjust a few different settings like auto night mode, which will automatically put the phone into night mode at the time that you specify, turning off all notifications if you have notifications turned on, and once in night mode, it'll also start tracking your sleep. You can select virtually any app to have notifications sent directly to the band, but the only thing the band does is vibrate, letting you know you have a new notification, so you'll still have to pull out your phone to find out exactly what it is. There's a couple of other features like the Smart Wake Up, which will wake you up if you're lightly sleeping, and the Out of Range alert for when you leave your phone or tablet behind. There's a few other applications that you can control from the Smart Band, like your music player and camera, but the implementation is rather clunky. For example, controlling your music player requires you to double tap to skip forward a track and triple tap to go back a track, and more often than not, when I wanted to go back a track, it registered my triple taps as double taps, making it easier to just pick up the phone and change the track myself. If you're more interested in just tracking your daily activities, the LifeLog app can help you do that. What makes the Sony Smart Band different from other fitness trackers is that it tracks more than just your fitness activities. On top of walking, running, and how many calories you've burned, it'll also keep track of other activities like social interaction, media consumption like music, movies, games, reading, browsing the web, and how many photos you've taken, provided you did it all on the phone that the band is paired to. The app is laid out in a very clean and visual manner, and the timeline at the top does a nice job of giving you an overall picture of your entire day. You can also bookmark parts of the day should there be anything memorable that you want to keep track of. There are some things that the Smart Band doesn't track that other fitness bands do, like biking and hiking, but Sony isn't necessarily advertising it as a full-fledged fitness tracker, as it's meant more for tracking your daily activities and overall lifestyle. When it comes to the battery life, it's got a tiny 35 milliamp hour battery inside, and Sony promises 5 days out of it, and that's exactly what I got. So I think 5 days is pretty good for a wearable device like this, and it also doesn't take long to charge either. It takes about 30 minutes to an hour to charge, and you'll be good to go for another 5 days. So I was very pleasantly surprised that it lived up to its claim, and I think it's quite impressive that it can actually last that long. You can purchase the Sony Smart Band now. It retails for $100, but you can already find it for cheaper through websites like Amazon. And I think it's pretty fairly priced, putting it directly in line with other competitors like the Fitbit. And it's certainly cheaper than something like the Nike Feel Band. The Sony Smart Band isn't perfect. I do think there's room for improvement. But if you're looking for a band that can track your fitness and various other activities throughout your daily life, the Sony Smart Band is a great option. And with all the information that it can track, it becomes more than just your average fitness tracker. But that is it for this review. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up down below. And also subscribe to the channel, which is also down below. And once you're done doing all that, make sure to check out the website at androidauthority.com. And once again, thank you so much for watching. Keep it locked on Android Authority, as we are your source for all things Android.